find out everyone's likes and dislikes so I know what to cook. Who knows when it'll be my turn at kitchen duty? How about you, Professor? Do you like sweet or spicy food? Spicy? Ooh, your tastes are so mature. I'll definitely remember that.
Absolute favorite! How did you know, Professor?
Wow, this is all kinds of tasty.
Would you kindly do something for me?
Sea of countless books, tracking down that single sought-after volume, it's absolute bliss. How do the poor fools who spend their days sharpening swords and polishing armor find any joy in life? Huh? However, I still have a lot of books I wish to read.
I'm so glad to be a student here, if only because I get to use this library. Reading books from all the regions of Fodlan, I feel almost like I'm visiting those places myself. I agree. They're brimming with the knowledge and experience of our ancestors.
Thanks for your help.
Thank you. Thank you for paying me a visit. Is there anything troubling you? Or is there perhaps something I can help you with? Believers live their lives by her sacred wisdom. Please use the library's vast resources to learn more. I can often be found here, so if there is ever anything you need, please do not hesitate to pay me a visit.
Excellent work guiding the students in the mock battle. Taking command like that? Simply splendid. And bearing the unknown crest's power? Yes, I'm talking about you. Your talents are incredible, and Lady Rhea's insight as to your potential is doubly so. You do seem to have a mark of the exceptional about you. I only wish Seteth would follow your example.
The Iyer family. We have long held the position of Prime Minister in the Empire. The Empire's power lies with 6 noble families, my family foremost among them. The full explanation may be time-consuming. I can give you a moment to get ready, if you would like to take notes. Alright, I will list the 6 great noble families. There is Caspar's father, Count Burgles, the Minister of Military Affairs. Then there's Linhart's father, Count Hevering, the Minister of Domestic Affairs. Bernadetta's father, Count Varley, is the Minister of Religious Affairs. Hubert's father, Marquis Vestra, is the Minister of the Imperial Household. Finally, we have Duke Gert, the Minister of Foreign Affairs, and my own father, Duke Iyer, the Prime Minister. One day, I will take his place as the Prime Minister of the Empire. I am more talented than anyone in my class, even Edelgard. I will lead the Empire to a bright, enlightened future. There is nothing I cannot achieve. Oh, Professor. Here to recruit me, I presume? Well, the eldest son of House Iyer will not be so easily swayed.
Here's an idea. I hear the Officer's Academy of the Monastery was founded about 2 centuries ago. The eastern region of Fodlan was being invaded by Almira, and so the Archbishop of the time took measures to prevent the border from being taken. In order to ensure Fodlan would be safe from potential threats, she deemed it necessary to raise a generation of excellence. That is how the establishment was founded, though its purpose has changed over the years. Favor to ask. The cathedral is nice and quiet. It's so relaxing. Oh, Professor, did you come to pray to the goddess? Me too. Shall we pray together? Oh, I'm already having so much fun in my current class. Sorry to disappoint.
So, inside the cathedral, there is a chapel dedicated to the 4 saints. Do you know of them? Saint Indec, Saint Macule, Saint Keyhole, and...
Saint Cephaline! Who is your favorite, Professor?
Now that you are a member of the church, be sure to familiarize yourself with our teachings and traditions. I have something to ask of you.
Professor, hello. I was just looking for my... Well, it's like a pale blue cloth. Have you seen it? Thank you so much. I do find you very interesting. What is it? I'm not doing anything! Cake? Oh, come on! That's just cruel!
Are you that new professor everyone's talking about? Name's Anna. I'm a merchant who slings wares all across Fodlan and beyond. I come in here all the time, so I'm sure our paths will cross more. Hopefully, much more.
You're a lifesaver.
Sounds fun. Let me show you my cooking talent. A little more secret spice, and... Hey! No peeking!
You know, sometimes I forget to eat. Does that ever happen to you?
Eating deli-
looks delicious. Goddess, forgive me. I've just got to indulge.
This is delicious!
Liking that. Ooh, I love this stuff. Did you know that?
Look bored. Care to duel? What? I just wanted to.
You there! Hey!
Hello there.
Oh, Professor! How are you today? I'm just heading out for a mission. I'll be seeing you. I don't need luck. This will be a piece of cake. I'll be back before you know it.
What?
I'm bored. Maybe I should go into town. But that would be such a hassle. Oh, hi, Professor. I'm rather busy right now, so do make it quick. Are you sure? I thought you'd found me out for a moment there.
Please. You know, Professor, there are some things I'll just never understand. Like the other night, I went on a date with a dashing, handsome, strong young knight. Oh, I'm a bit weak just remembering him. Anyway, do you know what that no-good jerk said when we got back to my room? He said, "What a mess. I'm afraid to go in there." Can you believe it? You know who cares about keeping everything neat and tidy? Not me, that's who. Afraid to go in there. Some knight he is.
Professor, nothing to report. Are you settled in here at the monastery yet? Make sure to have a good look around. There's much to see. Like fish. You do know about the pond behind the dining hall, right? You can fish there.
You can't be serious. I need your help.
Word of advice, Professor. There are those who don't think kindly of such people.
I was thinking.
My savior, thank you. Keep my voice down. Singing is...
Well done. You have my thanks.
There's something else. Something.
It is the duty of every Fodlan noble to demonstrate piety towards Seros. Have you also come to offer your prayers to the goddess, Professor? You don't sound terribly sure. Perhaps you are not of noble birth? After all, devotion is not...
Don't tell me. No one bothered to show you the standard procedure for lectures?
Thanks for taking...
Guess I missed... Don't start with me, buddy. I'm a well-oiled...
Question. I think I follow.
Professor. We'd better get to work.
We'll manage. Can't argue with results, can you?
Hmm.
Thanks.
Battalions are deployed in battle so students can learn how to take command. Oh, that concept may be new to a loner mercenary like you, eh, Teach? Want me to explain the basics? Stay focused.
I stand ready.
Leave it to me. Let's get to it.
I got this.
Let me at him.
Who, me?
Sally Ford!
Sure thing.
Ready anytime.
I won.
Yeah.
weather the storm, huh?
Too shabby.
I'll celebrate later.
Magnificent.
If you say so.
Won that.
Thank you.
A trivial victory.
No.
Don't forget who you're dealing with.
bad as that.
Up to you. Face it, I'm better than you. Luck is on.
You can't compete with me. I stand ready.
Ready anytime.
Who, me?
Let me at him. I got this.
Sure thing.
To it.
Sally Ford!
Stay focused.
To lose. I guess I... down.
It's good to be king.
Up to you. Sure thing.
Stronger than I look, yeah? Stronger.
Yeah. Thank you.
Favorite part. Can I get a...
I could use a break.
Thank you. Who, me?
Can't compete with me. I thought master
Professor.
I want to leave. Don't make me do this.
Singing's okay, but I should really have a cute dance to go along with it. Hey, Professor. What are you doing daydreaming in a place like this? It's lucky. As spacey as you are, you're always reliable in a pinch. Not as much as you. It's hard to tell what's going on in that skull of yours. Your expression is always blank. Come on, smile! I was just playing around. Don't get mad. By the way, in the next battle, may I focus on logistical support? Off the battlefield, there's no use having a weakling like me in the middle of the action. And it would bring down morale if I were killed. Have you even seen me, Professor? Look at these noodly little arms! I should be cheering everyone on from the sidelines. It'll certainly improve the boys' morale, don't you think? Because even if I do, I won't be of any help. My big brother is the type of person who's supposed to be on the battlefield. For me, it's just a waste of energy. It's pointless. Everyone's cut out for something different. The right person for the right task, you know? Please, Professor, keep me off the battlefield, and maybe I won't tell everyone you're daydreaming. That wasn't so bad.
Now I see the heart of it.
Better than before.
I feel like I get it now.
I think it's coming. Oh, yeah! Get...
A bit more skill never hurt.
Mastery is what... Guess I learned a thing or two.
Claude?
Hmm? Oh, Marianne. Have the gods taken pity on my lost soul and revealed a sign to me? I've been researching the 10 elites of Fodlan, but I can't tell fact from fiction. Anyhow, what can I help you with?
Well, I found this pendant, and I think it's yours.
Ah, right you are. Yeah, honestly, I'd resigned myself to never seeing it again. It's a keepsake from my uncle, who has passed on. If I truly lost it, my grandfather would have had my head. Thanks for returning it to me, Marianne. You saved my tail.
Please, it was nothing. I should be...
No, I think that's enough researching for today. Why don't you join me for a nice chat?
I just came to deliver the pendant.
Sounds awfully lonely to only talk to those whom you have business with. Do you really dislike talking to people that much?
It's just... I never know what to say. I'm sorry.
No need to apologize. We'll figure it out as we go. Tell me, are you like this with your father too? Within the Alliance, Margrave Edmund is prone to debate. With a father like that, I would have thought...
Margrave Edmund is my adoptive father.
Oh, is he? I didn't know. Where were you born?
That is none of your concern. I really must be going.
She's hiding something, that much is clear. But that just makes me all the more desperate to know her secrets.
New path to tread.
Perfect comprehension.
I see. It's all
my effort.
Hey, Teach. Glad you can make it. We've been waiting on you.
It seems the Knights have our foes cornered. They are in Xanado, the Red Canyon.
It's bandit time? That sounds like real Knight work. Let's get to it.
I'm itching to put my skills to the test as well. We have to win so Captain Gerald can see how much I've learned.
I thought Gerald wasn't coming with us. Either way, I'll give it everything I've got.
Even if I go, it's not like I'd be of any use. That's enough of that. If we don't work together and give it our all, we are doomed to fail. You can be pretty intense sometimes, Lysithia. But I agree. Let's do our best.
If we fight half as well as we chatter, we'll be fine. Come on, Teach. Lead the way.
So, we are taking children into battle, are we? I'm not certain I will be able to sleep soundly after beholding something like that. I shall allow you to turn back the hands of time. But no, this power is not infinite.
Thank you.
So this is the Red Canyon. Doesn't look red to me. Anyway, let's get things started, Teach. Looks like the thieves have been driven back. That's what we last heard, so no surprise there.
The knights chased us all the way here?
Chief, let's get out of here. There's no way we can win against them.
Shut your dumb mouth! Where would we go at this point? You can't be a thief if you fear death!
I hear there's a back road to the west. How about we split up and attack from there and from the front? We may be able to corner the enemy by approaching from both sides. In any case, we need to cross the bridge first. I'll leave the details to you, Teach.
Let's get to it.
I stand ready.
Stay focused.
Let me at him.
Ready anytime.
Who, me?
I got this.
Leave it to me.
Ready and willing.
Celebrate later. That? This is what I've dreamed. This is what I do. Precious opportunity to test my own strength. I won't make waste of your deaths. Forgive me, goddess, and save their souls.
Thank you.
Arms ready.
Goddess, protect me. Was that helpful? Is this...
It was a good try. We were taken by surprise last time, but I guess this is what we can expect when battling thieves.
Much needed. Is that?
We stole this treasure. It's all ours. There's no way we're gonna give it up to some knights.
It's not luck, it's fate. I expect...
Good to go.
Better be careful.
Who knew? I'm sorry, I did.
Ready and willing.
I stand ready.
You're outclassed. It is a noble's duty to guard the welfare of the people.
I got this.
Who, me? Leave it to me.
Stay focused.
Let's get to it.
Let me at him.
You
each battle a chance to grow.
Ready anytime.
I get things done.
Magnificent. I thought...
Damn! They're coming from the west, too! I can't stand these brats!
Well,
such
you were outmatched. It's over.
Stronger than I look, yeah?
I'm a bit uneasy. I actually won.
Sorry.
coward.
Good to go.
Won that. Make it.
All that work?
This is my first real fight. I guess I'm pretty strong.
Couldn't weather the storm, huh?
That helps.
Noble has nothing to do with who you are as a person or how hard your life is. Your logic is illogical.
Sending these brats instead of the knights means they've underestimated me.
Big mistake.
Let's get to it.
Got you covered.
Time to make my move.
I didn't expect that.
Never listen to that idiot. What a mistake.
try hard.
Those thieves ran out of luck when they entered this canyon. They never had a chance. Your leadership was amazing, Teach. Let's leave the rest of this work to the knights.
I wonder why it is that you recall this place. You must be weak of heart. Each time I speak, it scares you so. Although the battle's at an end, do not feel too at ease. Well, anyhow, I am quite fascinated by this place. As far as I can tell, this is your first time here. Here? I dare say it would be impossible to have forgotten such a place as this. I must admit I am unsure. Beyond the name and the strange feeling of familiarity, I can't seem to remember anything about this place. And yet, a great depth of emotions tied to that sense of familiarity. Like joy and sorrow, pain and love, and all things in between. If I was somehow here before, I wonder what took place.
Teach, what are you doing here? We should get back to the academy.
It is time to depart. But know that time reveals all things. One day, I will remember that which I have lost. Oh, by the way, it seems you've earned my gratitude. The thieves who came here are no more. I am not sure myself, yet I am grateful all the same. In any case, you must become accustomed to my voice. If you fall down with shock each time I speak, that just won't do. Oh, you think you're standing strong? Of course you are. It was a jest.
Hey, Teach. On the way back, you seemed transfixed by the canyon. Did something happen there? It seemed familiar to you? Huh, can't say the same. Maybe it's a memory from when you were a child, or from a past life. Anyway, if you can't remember, I guess there isn't really much more to be said. Although, I'll admit, there is something about that canyon that has me captivated as well. How did Xanado come to be called the Red Canyon? Nothing there was actually red.
So you have safely disposed of those bandits. I pray that their souls find salvation. But why did they target the students to begin with? We must further investigate the true cause of all that took place. Until we know more, I ask that you support the students and relieve them of any unnecessary worry. Good. I have high expectations for you. By the way, how was your time in Xanado? Legend has it, in ancient times, a goddess alighted upon this world in that very canyon. For a goddess from the heavens, Xanado could only have been a temporary haven. Long ago, the divine Seiros received a revelation from the goddess. A gift to help guide the lost. The goddess is always watching over Fodlan from her kingdom above. However, in ancient times, the goddess graced this world with her presence and offered salvation to the people here. She is the mother of all life, the arbiter of every soul. I see. During your time here, I pray that you come to devote yourself to the teachings of Seros.
Lady Rhea, I am sorry to interrupt. There is something I must ask about in regard to those bandits.
As you wish. We shall continue our discussion when next we meet.
A goddess? I have no memory of her. But then, I have no memory at all. Oh, how bothersome. It is as though I know, and yet I don't. Perhaps Xanadu was my home back when the goddess walked the land. If so, what does that make me now? A ghost? No, that cannot be. I am most certainly alive. Of course, we also have the mystery of why I'm here with you. Is it somehow connected? Perhaps some past regret is stopping me from moving on, and now I'm forced to stay with you instead. No, that's not it. I can't believe in such a meaningless existence.
Part 1. White Clouds. Garland Moon. Mutiny in the Mist. When the warm winds blow from the sea to the south of Adrestia, residents of Fodlan know that the rainy season is upon them. Before the heavy rains take their toll, young women hurry to pick the last of the white roses. The ivory buds are woven into garlands and given as gifts to close friends or potential lovers.
Professor, I have a new mission for your students.
We have received reports that Lord Lonato has rallied troops against the Holy Church of Seros.
Lord Lonato is a minor lord of the kingdom. He's been showing hostility toward the church for some time now.
A vanguard unit from the Knights of Seros is already on its way to his stronghold, Castle Gaspar. Lord Lonato's army is nothing compared to the Knights. It is quite possible the rebellion has already been suppressed.
Even so, I would like for your class to travel with the Knight's rear guard to deal with the aftermath.
War zones are unpredictable. We do not expect you will have cause to battle, but be prepared for the worst.
Excuse me. You sent for me, Lady Rhea?
This is Catherine. She will be leading the Knights whom you will be accompanying.
Nice to meet you. We've heard a lot about you. If you need anything, just ask.
She is one of our bravest knights, and that is no small feat. Only an exceptional few have what it takes to join the Knights of Seros. This mission should prove useful in demonstrating to the students how foolish it would be to ever turn their blades on the church.
Thank you so much.
Meat is
the best! Veggies and fish are great too, but there's nothing like a good cut of meat.
May I join you?
Hey, Lawrence.
You here to eat? It looks like you barely grabbed anything.
Please, this amount will suffice for me. There's no need to compare our portions.
No wonder you're so skinny. My little sis eats more than you. Come on, have some of mine. You need it more than I do.
You offer me half-eaten scraps? The nerve! With manners like that, even a nobleman would be an absolute disgrace. Have you no dignity?
You're pretty touchy, huh? It's probably just because you're hungry.
Raphael, please, do you mind? I cannot enjoy the simple pleasure of a meal in these conditions.
Why can't you enjoy your meal? You don't like what's on the menu? You wait here. I'll go to the kitchen and find something tastier for you.
That won't be necessary. Please, just let me eat. In peace. Alone.
I don't think you get it, Lawrence. Nothing goes with a meal better than good company. If leading the Alliance is your goal, you should really try eating with other people first.
I'm afraid I fail to see the connection between leadership and dining.
If you want to be a leader, you have to know how to get along with different types of people, right? If you really want to get to know someone, all you have to do is share a meal with them.
Quite the contrary, unfortunately. It seems the more time I spend eating with you, the less likely we are to become friends.
The more you eat with someone, the more you learn about them. Their likes, their dislikes, you know? You might get some of their food that way, too. You can eat more and bulk up. All that talking made me hungry again. I'm gonna go get seconds.
What an absolute bother. But I suppose he does have a point about observations of character at the dinner table. Ignatz, let us take a short break. I will pour tea. Please choose a teapot for us to use. I don't see any other Ignatz around here, do you? Go on now, we're wasting time. The pots are over here. I will leave the selection to your judgment.
Let's see. How about this?
That's rather plain. Why did you choose that one?
The tea you chose has a very subtle taste, as well as a smooth, light texture. Such an unassuming tea calls for an unassuming pot, and one that complements the tea's color. In addition, the pot I selected has a floral design. Although we can't go for a walk today, we can still bask a little in nature's beauty.
Very interesting. You know, you have an absolutely marvelous aesthetic eye. Precisely what I would expect from the son of a merchant house that has enjoyed the Gloucester's patronage for so many years. After we graduate, when you begin your trade in earnest, I will introduce you to my father.
Oh, that sounds wonderful. But I'm afraid I'm already on the path to becoming a knight.
Ah, right, you are a second son. Still, your eye for beauty is a talent that should not go to waste. Very well. If you are to be a knight, then I shall happily take you into my service. What, does that displease you?
Not at all. I just need a little time to think it over.
His eye for the arts is unwavering, but in all other matters he is woefully indecisive.